Baby, this is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves.
Good morning. It's the morning of the trip to St. Thomas. We're waiting on our Uber driver, Nakia, / my cousin, to get here to take us to the airport. So we're just chilling and waiting. Was that her? Making sure everything. Yeah.
Y'all have fun.
Okay.
I'll be watching like this.
Bob. Oh, I need my ID. I could check in from my phone. Huh? Oh, okay. I haven't flown in since 2009. So, this is like ultimate flying. Because I haven't flown, I've never flown across the sea, so.
Oh, I flew United the last time I seen you. I think you came and picked me up.
Yeah. Came and picked you up.
I think this is the wrong turn.
This is. She was supposed to pick a stay.
This is terminal B.
She's supposed to pick a stay.
This is straight in line. We can't go nowhere else.
We have to go down. You don't see this arrow? It says go down.
This is baggage claim. Oh, it's a terminal A. We gotta go to the other side because this is coming up.
Well, the other side does not currently work. So, I have no idea where we're going to go. We just got through TSA and I hadn't been on the plane since 2009, so that whole pose thing was new to me. Getting ready to load the plane! Super exciting!
I don't know what that means anymore.
We're headed to ATL. There she is.
Y'all, in case
you're
going back, you got to go to another terminal.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Great.
Welcome to the world's busiest airport, where we have over 250,000 people to make connections to here a day.
That's crazy.
Yeah, Nikki was like, yeah, it's a big airport.
That's why I was like, you can't throw us in.
Y'all don't have the foot. We have Corner Bakery.
This is crazy.
You got sidetracked.
My mother is giving me a workout. I'm walking so fast. I'm tired. I'm really getting my workout again. I probably have a million steps by now. So this is the front door. You walk in, to the right it's the restroom. It's a mini bar here, a fridge, and I believe it's a safe down there. Restroom, pretty nice. Ooh, pretty nice. And closet. Sink. The bed. TV. I'm loving this furniture though. Oh, mirror. Hey y'all. A little desk, side table with a chair, side bedside table, and our view. Yes, and my sugar on his phone. It's so pretty. Ocean view. St. John over there. So pretty. And that is the hotel room tour. Oh, they also gave us this rum punch when we came in, and it's awesome. Don't drink if you're not over 21. It's pretty awesome there. Yeah, so we're just gonna chill out for a bit and see what happens.
208, you see.
That's two.
We still gotta go this way.
So do we go that way?
No,
because
we gotta go.
To go that way?
No, it's open right here. You got your ID and stuff?
Yes. I had to remember.
207 through 230.
Is that 208?
Oh. This is it.
This
is it. For the left.
Mm-hmm.
This is it.
Mm-hmm.
Then he said, get on.
Mm-hmm.
Did he say, take it to tree? I think he said that.
He said, take it to tree.
He said, I'll tree y'all.
Close. Sesame.
Close hot dog. See, this element F.
It's hot.
Oh, all
right, come on. Do not feed the wildlife.
We were at building T. 208 was right here. We said elevate to the left. Right there. We went up one floor and came down the stairs.
Oh, there's a UR here, but no, it's not. I'm just gonna walk. Let's just explore for ourselves. We're on vacation.
Oh my gosh. All this noise? Because you want me to work the thong thing.
Nope. No. It is day two at the Sugar Bay Resort. We are now waiting on our tour trolley bus thingy to come so we can go take our day tour of the island. This is our view from the backside of the resort. Good time, so we'll see you on the bus.
So, welcome to Sunalist. We're heading towards downtown. We're gonna stop at the West Indian Company Limited. I'm gonna pick up 4 more passengers out here.
Okay.
And the tour consists of shopping, sightseeing, beach, bring it back. Once you get up to the beach, if you're not beaching, 10-15 minutes, look around, take pictures, use the bathroom, walk out. And the tour continues. If you're swimming, you're getting 2 hours on the beach, I also gotta pick up time to bring it back. Elvis, also your tour guide. Sonny's on vacation, he'll be back Wednesday.
Okay.
Now here, down to your left, we have Linquist Beach, nice beach, pay like $5 to get to inside. That beach, Linquist Beach, Megan Bay, those are the two beaches you better go on. The other beaches are pretty much free. The more you make, the more you pay. The less you make, the less you pay. And it's all subsidized by the local government.
Congressman for us in D.C. 11 can secretary also to name the federal building here after him. Next building north of the federal building, we do have Alexander A. Fowley Justice Center. Alexander A. Fowley, he was an ex-governor, front part of this building. Our territorial court at the back end of it, underneath local police station. On top of the police station, there goes our local prison. Our prisoners here have the best seat in the house, Ocean View. Here to your right, Fort Christian parking lot, straight ahead of the parking lot is the old fort. Old fort once used to be the old prison back in those Danish time. Now today, t-shirt, bags, caps, wrap around, also your souvenir.
So Tim and I just got off the tour bus. We are out here next to the little shops and we're gonna go shopping for a little bit and then we're going to see what's next.
Thank you.
God just offered. just offered us
some special trees. And he was like, everything right here is just jewelry and clothing
and liquor.
And if you're looking for something else, like special trees, I got you. He was like, no worries. It's legal here.
It's legal here. I'm not the police. Dude.
Yeah, that guy we were just talking about.
No, hold on.
Yeah, so that guy that was just offering us those special trees, it was in that drug free zone we just captured on the last report or that picture there. I don't know what to say about
that. How you special trees, drug free zone.
A chance to shop around town, we're going sightseeing. We're gonna get up to mountaintop. You also could do a little bit of shopping right there. And if you look here to your right, we have the Emancipation Garden, and to your far
$1 worth of gold. St. Thomas, St. John, St. Paul. Now today, the island in the background, Water Island, became the fourth Virgin Island back in 1996. Water Island is a little different. Most of the folks that lives out there, retire America. Out there you have no bar, no restaurant, no doctor's office, and no beauty saloon to beautify all the beautiful ladies here with us today. Strictly residential area. Okay. You go back and forth using the water taxi from down in the suburbs. You know, the channel way,
you can buy a lot of
St. Thomas once used to be together.
Okay.
The Danish government made the separation between the two islands so the water can flow to them and the smaller vessels can come to. That island today run by the National Park of America. You see that building with the white flag, red flag, two flag poles. The flags are half mast today. They are slaying in Dallas with those police officers. The flags are at half mast. But that building, that's our White House. There's where our governor lives, Governor Kenneth E. Mack. Now straight ahead, two flags: the American flag, the Virgin Islands flag. We have Blackbeard's Castle. Blackbeard was an English pirate that came to this island. He got married 14 times. His first 13 brides are killed by him on their wedding night. She got married and no sailing, never brought back home those ladies. He get away with 13 because you know what? His 14 bride did him in. And that's the lady I fell in love with. The 14 bride is my girl. You see those two big buildings on the water? One to your, the yellow and white, silver line and red top, that's the federal building. And the building north of it, Alexander A. Fowley Justice Center. That building, we also call it the Free Hotel, guys. You're here with us today, you come back here any other time, and you decide you want to stay in that free hotel, all you have to do to get down there is commit a small crime. Because that's the prison right there. You hit Now straight ahead, you have 1, 2, 3 white building with the red top. Building in the middle, nice burgundy flowers. You go left, white building, you go straight out, white building, red top, 2 trees in the background. Uh-huh. Then you have a castle, round castle with a silver cross on top of it. Oh. You guys following me?
Yeah.
That's Bluebeard's Castle. Bluebeard also was an English pirate that came to this island. He built a castle for his love of his life. And when that lady deceived him, you know what he did? Took a sailing, caught a neck on, never brought her back home. So what he did with that area today, they developed into hotel and timeshare. Now most of you guys from the ship, your ship at the West Indian Company Limited. But if you look, Straight ahead that building on the edge, Marriott French Marif, it's a 5-star hotel. Now on a good day, visibility-wise, you stay here and see St. Croix. You cannot see today, because it's a little too hazy. But St. Croix, 40 miles south of us, St. Croix is the biggest Virgin Island out of all four islands. 84 square miles, population 160,000. St. Thomas, that's not 160, but 60,000. St. Thomas, 32 square mile, population 55,000. Water Island, 2.5 square mile, with a population of 50,000. St. John's, 4.5 square mile, with a population of 4,000. Now, Governor Kenneth Emap, he's from St. Paul. The Lieutenant Governor, Oswald Potter, he's from St. Thomas. We have 15 senators. 7 represent St. Thomas, 7 represent St. Croix, 1 at large represent St. John. We also have a Congress lady that represents the Virgin Islands in the House of Congress, Washington, D.C. Her name is Stacey Plaskett, and she's from the island of St. Croix. Now, last election, we put up 3 guys from St. Thomas to run against her. She beat out all 3 guys. So I'd like to say power to you, ladies. Now, back here, we have the Lionel Roberts Stadium. They play softball, baseball, and football. Now, the building back here now with the white top, with the blue, that's the old hospital. The reason why we call it the old hospital, we don't have a brand new hospital on the other side of town. So the health department used this building for their businesses, offices. Yellow building, red top, hillside condos. And guys, all these homes up in the hill. You go to your right, you go straight up, you go to your left. All these homes pretty much owned by local folks. What they does here, they build them big. You as the owner, you decide which floor you want to live on. Then they put the rest into apartments, in that way, the tenants help.